Will you sell your soul to make your dreams come true? You do whatever it takes to get to the top, but sometimes the stakes are too high. You lose so much of yourself getting there.
Oh, you better put that nasty-ass tongue back in your mouth or rip it out.
Yes, ma'am.
All of them. You name your biggest black actors. You name your biggest white actors. You name your biggest female Latino actresses. They all have to do it. A blood oath. Now you bend over. Now every orifice that you have is going to be annihilated.
This Sanford and Son actor recently came out with what it took to reach the top of his game in Hollywood. He had seen it all and was forbidden to talk about it until now. He was a decorated Army veteran, a top-selling Hollywood actor, and an author, and he even became an ordained minister. Demond Wilson told the media,
"You cannot make it to the top in that industry without selling your soul."
Grady Demond Wilson was born to a devout Catholic family in Valdosta, Georgia on October 13, 1946. They lived in Sugar Hill, Harlem, an area that was home to many showbiz personalities of that time. Their home was on a four-story high-rise, and his mother had to go up and down four flights of stairs, which ultimately led to her having two miscarriages. When Demond's mother was pregnant with him, she decided to move in with her mother in fear of another miscarriage. She did not want to lose the baby again, as she was already 46 years old. During an interview, Demond Wilson said that his mother had told the family, "This one is my last chance, and he is going to be special." His mother stayed with her parents until little Demond was about 1 month old.
She went to stay with her mother so she wouldn't have to traverse, go up and down stairs. She wanted to keep this one. She said, "I feel like this one is my last chance, and he's going to be special."
Demond felt so attached to his hometown, Valdosta, as his grandparents, parents, and sister were buried there. He grew up in New York City and studied ballet and tap dancing as a child at the Hoskins School of Culture. He learned basic ballet there, but did not want to pursue ballet because other kids in the block would harass him. Demond was talented, making his Broadway debut at age 4. He danced at the Harlem's 1,500-seat Apollo Theater when he was just 12 years old. Age 13 was a critical year for young Demond. His appendix ruptured, and he almost died from complications. During the illness, he vowed to serve God in a ministerial capacity when he reached adult life. Demond Wilson joined the United States Army in the 4th Infantry in 1966. "It was horrible," he says. "It was not something I wanted to talk about too much. I was in one of the first waves to go to Vietnam, but it was hell. And when I returned home, I was not welcomed back. I went for a job interview at Wall Street in uniform. The people in the subway were jeering at me and calling me a murderer."
And on top of that, when I came home, walked down the street with my uniform on in New York City, I went down to Wall Street. My nephew had an interview for me on Wall Street, and I went down, I wore my uniform. And people were jeering me in the subways and calling me murderer. And so when I hear people say, "Thank you for your service," it's like, it's almost like a joke.
He served in Vietnam till 1968, when he was wounded and returned to the USA. Demond was featured in several Broadway stage productions as a decorated war hero before moving on to Hollywood. Demond Wilson did his first movie in Toronto, Canada, and moved back to Hollywood. His acting career in Hollywood started with guest appearances in TV series, such as Mission Impossible. Demond starred in the 1971 movie The Organization and All in the Family as well, before his big break in television. Would you believe the star of Sanford and Son didn't even want to watch a television series at first?
"I don't watch episodical television. Get out of here." And he said, "They want you to do a spot." I said, "I don't want to do television. I'm a stage movie actor. I don't want to do television."
Demond Wilson's success was in television, though he did not realize it then. His agent called him one day and asked him whether he was willing to do a television network show opposite Red Fox. Of course, Demond was interested. Red Fox would play the father and Demond would play the son. So the famous Sanford and Son series was born. Demond flew to Las Vegas with show producers to meet Red Fox, an established comedian at that time.
So I went to Vegas and I met Red, and he was Red. I'd never met in my lifetime anyone like Red Fox.
They had to wait till Red Fox finished his midnight show to meet him. It was almost 3 a.m. and they were waiting in the garage when he finally got off the stage. Demond and Red hit it off at the first meeting. Red told Demond,
"Hey, Demon." He called me Demon. He said, "Hey, Demon, you the smartest nigga I've known since now."
When they first met, Red and Demond's relationship was something like a teacher and student, Demond says. The relationship they had on screen was exactly like the relationship they had off screen. Later, it developed into an older brother, younger brother relationship, as Redhead turned 50 when they started filming, and DeMond was 25 years old. They had good chemistry between them off-screen and on-screen, which was apparent during the show.
But Red and I had the relation, and nothing came between that relationship until he went to the newspaper and said he didn't want to do the show again, and that hurt me.
NBC ran the Sanford and Son series from January 14, 1972 to March 25, 1977, completing six seasons. While Red Fox starred as Fred Sanford, a widowed junk dealer, DeMond Wilson portrayed the long-suffering son. Though both of them had equal shares in the business, most of the time, the son, Lamont, played by DeMond, did all the work. The show was a ranking hit and acted as an inspiration for many other Black American sitcoms, which were produced later. While the show was a hit and both Red and DeMond made a lot of money, things did not end well for Red. Fox reportedly earned $4 million in a single year, but his fortune quickly depleted due to his lavish lifestyle and bad financial management. In 1983, Red filed for bankruptcy, and the proceedings continued until 1989, with the IRS filing a tax lien against his property for $996,000. That would be more than $2 million in today's value. The IRS seized his belongings, leaving just his bed. DeMond Wilson was frank about Red going broke. "I have no empathy for people who do things to themselves. If the world kicks you in the head, it is one thing, but when you don't do what you're supposed to do, I have no sympathy or empathy at all." Do you know that DeMond Wilson has been married for 49 years? Not only did they stay married for almost a half century, but they also brought up six children together. Growing up in Harlem, DeMond enjoyed the love of both of his parents. His wife, Cecily Johnston, whom he married on May 3, 1974, also had her parents caring for her during her childhood. During a YouTube interview, DeMond said their two-parent background helped them stay together for a long time.
Divorce when I grew up was not something that you talked about too much because it wasn't prevalent.
Divorce was not something that was around me. Most kids had a mom and a dad growing up in Harlem those days.
This single mother thing, I don't need no man, that's post-nonsensical. I mean, and now you see what's happened.
DeMond strongly felt a son needs a father figure at home to guide him into manhood.
And I'm not saying that a woman can't raise a male child, but you can't teach, a woman can't teach a boy how to become a man. She just can't do it. She can love him and nurture him and put all of that feminine energy into him so that when he comes out here, this world would chop him up.
DeMond felt the feminist movement is also responsible for single families, lesbianism, and its effect on society. During an interview, he directly blamed the Black Panther Party, which was active in the USA from the 1960s to 1980.
And the penal systems are single family. I don't need no man. All of those lesbians back in the day, Gloria Steinem, Black Panther woman that teaches at Stanford University, they were lesbian. The Black Panther Party was a communist organization that was funded by the Rockefellers.
How do you feel, guys? Do you agree with DeMond Wilson's wisdom on single parents and divorce? DeMond thinks you go in for the long haul when you get married. I married with that intent.
A marriage with the intent that people my age at that time went into a marriage for. These people today have contracts. Okay, you do this, you do that, you do that, you do that. There's no such thing as irreconcilable differences. That's a term that lawyers made up, just like conspiracy theorists.
DeMond Wilson's idea on conspiracy theory is quite interesting. He feels it's a term made up by the FBI. When the FBI published its findings of the JFK assassination, many people believed that one bullet did not hit JFK, went out, hit another person, and ended up in a garbage can.
They said, well, if you say anything other than what we say happened, you're a conspiracy theorist. They made that term up.
When you hear the word Hollywood, what comes to your mind? A glamorous world of beautiful actresses? But DeMond thinks it's one big factory.
Hollywood is a tiny little place of factories. I worked at an NBC factory, a CBS factory, an ABC factory. So Hollywood does me thing to me. I went to a factory and I went to work.
DeMond walked away from a successful Hollywood career to become a full-time preacher in 1982.
1982, I went full-time into the ministry. The Lord called me full-time into the ministry.
I preached before thousands in Africa and China, he said. DeMond Wilson is 77 years old and lives in Palm Springs, California, with his wife, Cecily. He devotes his time to writing and his work for the Lord in the twilight years of his life. Are you intrigued by his outspoken philosophy on feminism and single parents? If you'd like to take a trip down memory lane and find out more about Black celebrities and their lives, subscribe to our channel.